Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a multi-platinum Grammy-nominated super producer who's made hits for people like T.I., Ludacris, Snoop, Dogg, and Jay-Z.
He's now combining his passion for music and kids with an educational tool he calls Koolriculum.
Okay, then.
Okay, that helps kids flourish in math, science, social studies. Please welcome multi-platinum producer, Dr. Kevin KHAO.
Yes! Yes!
Awesome. How are you guys?
All right. I'm all right with you.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah. Now, KHAO, tell us how you got into the music industry.
Man, music has been a part of my life since I was, 10 years old. Uh-huh. It's something I always knew I was going to do. I used to take my G.I. Joes and do concerts. Right. I just, knew music was that. But, coming up from Montgomery, Alabama, I got in the mix of music doing everything, whether it was I was running a nightclub before I was old enough to be in one.
Wow.
I was producing, managing artists, and just waiting on that right opportunity to hit. So that's just been it.
Yeah. Now, what is it about writing and producing that really kind of stuck with you? Why did you choose that role as opposed to being an actual artist?
You know what? My main mission was to be an artist. Mm-hmm. But I realized in order to make it happen, you have to serve and actually, create an opportunity to help someone else. So that's how it really hit. I started making beats of what I thought I would want to rap to, and then it just stuck, and the production just took
just
off
worked.
From there.
Yeah.
Well, you took a break from the industry for a minute. Could you tell us a little bit about why you decided to do that?
Yeah, it was, time to where in the height of my career, actually. Mm-hmm. My dad passed away, and my dad would always say, don't just be successful, be significant and leave a legacy behind.
My God.
That's when I realized that the things that I was doing, they weren't as, it wasn't as exciting to me anymore. Mm-hmm. And I started searching for significance. And there was an award show I was being honored at, and the president of the SCLC, Dr. Charles Steele, came to this hip-hop award show and apologized to everyone in the room for not passing the torch and said it was a lot we can learn from each other. And that's when I realized that our generation is so busy chasing the money, we're repeating that process.
Yeah.
So I knew that I needed to do something. And I knew that the road to success, was me being homeless, sleeping in my car and other things. So why would the road to significance be any different as far as taking that leap? So my wife and I, she supported me, and we went all in. I took that step away, invested over $1.5 million,
my goodness,
of just household money to just pour into our youth, wrote a textbook. Megan Good and myself actually teaches the course via videos, and we're in schools across the nation.
Bad Brains, what is it?
That's the album.
So who you work with on that album?
My album is coming soon, actually, first of the year, and it's my comeback, and it's so amazing how God just brings things full circle. But in this case, it's never been done. I have over 65 artists on 13 songs.
Wow. What?
It's my Quincy Jones meets Khaled on steroids project.
Right.
And I'm bringing in legends with the artists who are hot now, and infusing records. So you got everyone from Red, Method Man, Busta Rhymes, DMX. But then you also got your Gucci Mans, your Lil Babies, your YB in the Mirrors, your NBA Young Boys,
Lil Wayne. Up on the album.
Oh,
my God.
It's
going to be ridiculous.
It's insane.
From that lineup alone.
That's a concert.
When I tell you, in an album.
Hello, somebody.
So the fact that you're serving is obviously serving you back.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Your nonprofit Bridge the Gap is something that you're also passionate about.
Definitely.
Tell us about your nonprofit and your initiative behind it.
Okay, so that's definitely where the time was taken out. And with Bridge the Gap, Megan Good is one of my partners. I created a textbook that teaches character building and life skills through music.
Mm-hmm.
And I produce songs for each chapter. So we're teaching the kids patience, self-determination, self-love, watching the company you keep, how to deal with losing loved ones through hip-hop, and then Megan and myself teaching it.
Oh, that's good. Falls under the umbrella of Koolriculum?
It's kind of like Bridge the Gap is my nonprofit, and Koolriculum came into effect after helping so many kids, and then the superintendent saying, well, what do you have to help with test scores?
Right. Mm.
So then I started producing over 600 songs that teaches math, science, social studies, and English through music, and made videos for it. So they learn through actual hip-hop.
They said we got a little piece of video. Let's check it out.
Cool.
Hi, my name is Chloe, and today I'm going to be talking about
And we got the
bomb. Oh, my God.
That is the bomb. When I tell you, that's the bomb.
Well, here's the, I love the concept because basically it's like when you're listening to music, this is how kids learn.
Yes.
When you're
exactly.
listening to music in a car, right? All right. the rap music that comes on the radio, whatever songs, they know those words, but they know them by rhythm. This is what you've done.
I'm telling you, and that's how you learn. Let me tell you something. I'm going down to the YouTube. Dr. Kevin, we are so happy to have had you down here. Thank you so much for being with us today and keep on doing the great work that you are doing.